Yo, Young Gravy is hilarious. Don't ask me how I know this, but he follows a couple of porn stars on Insta. All right, maybe I know this because I follow them, and you know how it says like you and so and so follow this person. It's literally like me and Gravy that followed like three or four porn stars, and I'm just like, okay. And he's commented a couple times on their pics.
Yep.
And he gets that action.
Yeah, yeah, baby. It's the golden chain.
The Hamm Planet Podcast.
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 The Hamm Planet Podcast is quite literally the best thing I've ever
found. Unbelievable stories.
The best.
It's hilarious.
Great vibes.
It was electric.
It's beauty like driving.
Good vibes and good stories.
Just a grand, good old time.
Simply Planet Podcast, number one.
We're happy to see you.
And lift off.
Shall we head to my favorite planet in the galaxy? The planet of good vibes. The planet of good vibes.
The planet.
It's time!
All right, all right, all right.
I love humanity. I think it's great.
It's all good, man.
I think the word you're searching for is Space Ranger.
The Hamm Planet Podcast.
Excuse me, come on.
Now that the fire has been set, we are blasting the galaxy of good vibes in the front. Five, four, three, two, and one. Top of the morning, folks. Good afternoon and good evening, ladies and gents. Welcome to the Hamm Planet Podcast. I'm your host, Peter Hamm. And if you're new to the show, we love to see it. We really do. We're all about three things here at the Hamm Planet Podcast: good vibes, great people, glorious stories. If you're into those things, you like those things, or you respect those things, you're at the right place, I'll tell you that. Ladies and gents, we have a fantastic show ahead on this mighty fine evening. We have a few Culver gentlemen reunited on Flathead Lake in Montana. It is September 2022. Ladies and gentlemen, the first scholar and gentleman joining us this evening, the one and only, Mr. Quinlan Smith. Let's give it up.
Glad to be here.
Glad to have you here, brother. And next on the docket, returning to the show also, Mr. Aaron Arvizu.
Yes, sir. Thanks for having
me,
Peter.
Give it up.
And of course,
ladies and gentlemen, the beautician himself, the Indiana Filipino cowboy, Mr. Justin Sitjar. Fire me up.
Big vibes, yes.
Big
we love
vibes.
To see
huge
it.
Vibes.
Well, brother, thank you. Boys, we are here amongst the mountains in Montana once again. Our ninth year. Quinlan, how many years do you envision this tradition will last?
As long as I'm alive.
That's a good point.
How long are you going to be alive?
I don't know.
The longest.
I don't know. But I mean, if it was a competition, I think I'd win.
Exactly.
So.
That's how you have to frame it.
You're a healthy person. Right. You have good cardiac health.
I tried to just have a Klondike bar, but that's okay.
I do.
Everybody loves a Klondike bar. I've heard.
Klondike bar ain't going to kill you.
I mean, it could.
But well, if you eat too
objectively.
Many.
Objectively.
If you eat too many. So it's 9 years. I like to say 9 years going on 90. Thoughts?
9 on 90. I like that.
So let's anyway. Fast forward the clocks. 90 years from now, how old are we going to be? We're 27, 28 at this current time.
Yeah, 117. I don't see it happening.
You're a math guy. 117.
Yeah.
Don't see it happening.
Not a math guy. Not a math guy.
Yeah.
Here.
I don't think any of us. Look, None of us are math guys.
Sorry, technical difficulties. Cameraman is drunk. Back to the show now.
For the sensation. Whoa. Prepare yourselves for something real, real marvelous.
And see it. Love it. Love to see it. Back to the show.
These trips, I know they're only once a year, but they come by kind of quick.
Are
I mean,
doing Ironman?
Whoa.
I can't run more than a mile without collapsing.
Yep.
So
I don't, that's
I don't think you should admit that happening. As a fitness guru.
Oh, I don't do cardio. Hard pass on cardio.
He is a bodybuilding influencer on social media.
Not quite.
Follow him on TikTok. Quinlan, what's the TikTok?
I think it's just Quinlan Smith.
You think?
I think it's Quinlan Smith.
I thought it was Pterodactyl Quinlan.
No, that's my Instagram.
Okay.
I should probably change that.
No, I think it's good. It's classic. It's a classic.
You know, you guys know how that nickname came from.
No, tell us.
Tell us, brother. How did Quinlan Pterodactyl Smith come to fruition?
It was actually back when I played tennis at Culver, and a couple people started calling me Pterodactyl. I don't know if you remember this, Aaron.
I don't.
But
from our sponsors.
Howdy there, ladies and gents. It's your good friend, Commercial Break Peter. Here to let you know that today's episode is brought to you by Unify Commerce. Say it with me now, Unify Commerce. Yes, guys, that is spelled U-N-I-F-I, commerce.com. Guys, Unify is in fact my company, and I thought I'd go ahead and plug them on here so you guys can know a little bit of what I do outside of having a great time on the podcast. Guys, Unify is a social technology company that simply helps other companies take their social presence to the next level. Simple as that. And the primary service I want to highlight is professional video creation. Guys, if your company is in need of an exceptional video that shows what you do, why you do it, how you do it, and why it is so valuable, then Unify is here to help. And Unify can create an exceptional advertisement that can really help build awareness and drive sales for your company. We have been in business since the summer of 2018, and helping businesses grow, capitalize on the opportunities that social presence can offer is something we love to do. So if you need a next level video, you need a next level team on your side, and that is Unify. So guys, go ahead and visit unifycommerce.com if you want to learn more. And if you want to inquire about working with us, simply go to the Work With Us tab and we would love to connect. Anyways, y'all, back to the show.
They said I moved across the court like a pterodactyl because it just flew back and forth.
Okay.
That was it.
Which, ladies and gentlemen, Quinlan, hell of a tennis player. Hell of a tennis player. As you can imagine, a pterodactyl, wide spread animal.
A quick pterodactyl, yeah. That's scary.
Large.
Yeah.
Fucking aggressive and shit. Dinosauric like. Big animal. Good on the course.
Big fucking animal.
Can win. Is that your favorite dinosaur?
No.
You're a Triceratops guy.
I'm not a Triceratops guy.
Okay.
Thank God. Not a Triceratops guy. Yeah. Fucking Triceratops guys. Hate to see him. No, I mean, it might be cliche. I'm a Velociraptor guy. Love it. Love the dexterity.
Okay.
Just like the
dexterity.
Oh my God.
What does that mean?
Highly intelligent.
They are. The Velociraptor is one of the smartest creatures, I mean, up there in humanity.
I like the dinosaurs with the long ass necks.
Bronchiosaurus,
the long necks.
Brother. Bronchiosaurus.
Bronchiosaurus, yeah.
Or
I like the
long neck if you want to get technical.
Yeah.
Or finacnical.
Untechnical.
Oh,
objectively.
We're not scientists.
We're not scientists.
Justin, scientist.
Big time.
Justin, actually a mental health expert. Justin, how happy is each one of us right now on a scale of 1 to 10? Let's go with Quinlan first. You can include decimal points.
You can lie for mine.
We cannot lie. It's
yeah, don't lie.
It says in the bottom of the email, this is
Thou shalt not
lie.
Goliath. Goliath.
Right, so what's Quinlan on a 1 to 10 right now? Just happy. Let's just do a rapid fire.
Like
just
in life or in this moment?
In this moment.
I had a Klondike bar like 10 minutes ago, so.
All right, don't factor that in. Yeah, give Quinlan a number.
As a, in as this a moment, mental though. Health expert's opinion.
Yeah.
What does he look like?
I mean, Quinlan always has a goofy smile, so. But you know that when he has a goofy smile, he's feeling good. Because he's always feeling good. So.
Exactly.
Solid
8
right now.
Solid Quinlan Smith checking in at 8.0 happy. Now we have Aaron.
8.0.
Aaron Arvizu.
Aaron's at a solid 7 right now.
7 sounds good.
He's less happy than Quinlan, but he is still happy.
If it was a competition, I would win, to clarify.
Justy?
Peter?
What's Peter clocking in at?
Peter's probably clocking in at like a 9.5
square. Oh, nice. Sure. Happiest nice. In the crowd.
Sure.
Except Justin's clocking in at a 9.
That becomes a little manic
nine.
At some point, right?
Wow.
What's that?
That's I'm just saying, once you get past like 9, it starts getting a little creepy. That's just like, you know, you're like, you know, it's like,
no, it doesn't.
Joker vibe.
I just always have.
I got my wisdom teeth out 3 weeks ago. No I was shit. Feeling exactly like that.
Dude,
ooh.
Until I recovered and then had just massive holes in my mouth, and I could only eat Jell-O and applesauce for 2 weeks.
Do you have chubby beaver cheeks?
No, actually. Oh. I had no swelling at all.
Did you walk back after your appointment or did you have it in the city?
I had two of my buddies from Middlebury came. One of them walked me back. They made sure I was
you
alive.
Didn't get thrown in the car.
Nice.
No, it was just like a 10-minute walk. It was a 10-minute walk from my studio.
Sure.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, wisdom teeth. They put some goofy stuff in you. I don't know, but
I just did general anesthesia, and so I was like out like a light. Like a light. I woke up and I did not think they had done the surgery yet.
Sure. Are you good now though? Bounce back.
Oh,
full recovery.
We're good. We're moving and grooving. This is like 3 or 4 weeks ago, a month ago. Okay. Before, yeah.
I got my wisdom teeth ripped out as an 11-year-old.
Jeez.
Was too manly.
That's early.
Yep.
I guess so.
No, what actually happened, believe it or not, was I was supposed to have a jaw procedure to open up my airway due to the airway being 3 millimeters.
You were snoring too loud?
No, this man can snore, my goodness.
The lack of snoring.
Hey, guys, I'm single. Don't be telling that shit.
JK.
JK, lady.
That we were JK, very much JK. Joking. There's no snoring at all.
Huge muscles. We're about to get surgery for the airway, and they were going to expand it from 3 millimeters to 12. They were going to have to break the jaw to do it.
Here. Around the Adam's apple.
Around that. It's in there.
Okay.
There's a lot of shit going on in there. I learned.
Yeah, I have no idea.
Yeah, I was going to have to get my jaw broken and my wisdom teeth out. So got my wisdom teeth out first and then begged my mom not to give me the surgery, not to allow the surgery.
His dentist mother, by the way.
Right. Who was advocating for it. We turned out just fine. Bro, I would have had my jaw broken for my freshman year of high school.
Yeah, that would have been tough.
Yeah, not doing that.
Wait, so your mom said don't do it?
No, I said I don't want to do it.
Oh, okay.
There's no way I'm doing it.
Shit.
A year out of sports?
Yeah. Yeah, that'd be too much. Like when you're first getting to Culver, trying to make a name for yourself, I can see that.
Yeah. And you're going through puberty, bro?
Yeah.
Hell no. Need all my shit fucking on.
Good move. No, good choice. Good choice.
On fleek. But anyways, yeah. Anyways, there was that. So got my wisdom teeth out then, and it was pretty loosey-goosey for
loosey-goosey.
About 5 hours, and then I took some sort of something that made me fall asleep for a couple days.
Nice.
Klondike bar.
Yeah, a really good Klondike bar.
And now a message from our sponsors, Klondike.
Klondike, they're not our sponsors.
You love to see them.
We do love to see them. Quinlan, what's your favorite ice cream that if you owned them, you would fill up a pool with their ice cream and jump into it?
It'd have to be some soft serve ice cream, because I mean, you get some frozen ice cream, you jump into a pool of that, and you can have more than just a torn bicep.
Do you think you'd get severely injured if you jump?
Yeah, it depends on how far. I mean, think about like jumping into like water from like 30 plus feet, like it hurts. Now imagine something significantly more solid than water.
All right, let's just scratch the whole jumping into like the pool. How about just for you?
Yeah. Well, one of the few things I could eat was ice cream when I got my wisdom out. So I went and I would get Ben and Jerry's mint chocolate chip cookies and cream.
Mm.
Outstanding.
Sure.
Outstanding.
Who is Quinlan Smith in five words?
And how about in less than 10 words?
I'll give you three words. I'll give you three words. I like to define myself in three words. It's be strong, be smart, and be kind. And those are the three words, the three things that I try and live by.
You love to see it, ladies and gentlemen. Just give it up. Let's give it up. Give it up. Up, 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 up. Quinlan, that warms the heart. I like that. And those were all words that people can understand. I'm surprised there's no SAT, you know. Top Middlebury vocabulary.
You don't need it.
Aaron, three words. Who is Aaron Arvizu?
Three words. I don't know if I can do three words, but I'll give you my line that I've.
Went out to the square number. Okay.
Yeah. The people I've met, the places I've been. That's who I am.
I love that.
Yeah.
And if you have a good memory, you know that Aaron said that last time he was on the show.
That's right.
Right. Love to see it.
I can't believe that was a year ago. Crazy.
That was. Mm-hmm. Justin, who is Justin Sitjar in three words?
I'll give you three words. Calm, cool, and collected.
Nice.
Calm, cool, and collected. Those are three things I want in a best friend. No doubt about it. When it boils down to it, you need those things. Love to see it.
What about you, big fella? Give me your three.
Three. Well, maybe I'll go the sentence approach to balance it out.
Okay.
What you know and who you know is who you are.
Okay. I'll take it. I think mine's better, but it's all good.
If it was a competition, I'm just saying if it was a competition, we tied. All great. You love to see it.
Okay.
Rare to see from Quinlan. Quinlan usually likes to win and or see others lose. And
real dark side of me, dark, working on it, actively working on it.
See, we see the
making
scary movie
very little
side.
Progress.
We see the, yeah, we see that.
Do you love winning more or do you hate losing?
That's actually such a good question.
Good question, Quinlan Smith, to you.
Do I love winning or do I hate losing more? God, I fucking hate losing. I hate losing. Yeah. Winning's great, but like, man,
you don't want a second.
Man, losing is
tough.
I don't know where that was drilled into me or like how, because like I have two older sisters and like they're competitive to a degree, but like, I don't know. I got to work on it, but it's a big part of what drives me too, right? So I don't think I would be where I am today. I didn't fucking hate losing so much.
I agree, Quinlan. You do fucking hate losing and go insane if you lose.
Yeah.
Which you love to see it. Competitive spirit alive and well. Aaron, do you love winning or hate losing more?
Definitely love winning, for sure.
Love winning.
Oh yeah, in any type of setting.
You got the LeBron approach. Go to as many championships as you can and get what you can.
That's a little unfair, but yeah, we'll take that.
You know, to chime in, I have the same approach. I love winning more. I always view losing, which, hate losing. Losing's shitty.
Mm-hmm.
But always have the approach that you never lose. You just learn.
Yeah, exactly. You learn and you get better. Small example, golf today. I'm terrible. I lost. But what drives me is to keep, A, I love it. It's so fun. And B, getting better so that you can win, right?
Yeah.
Really shitty example, but God damn it, I got to get better. And it's just so fun.
Good example.
Yeah.
Justin, do you love winning more or hate losing?
There's probably some psychological reason behind that. I'm pretty sure you could pipeline.
Yeah, there's something wrong with us. I don't know. So at least we've acknowledged.
Yeah, I don't know there's anything wrong. If anything, there's going to be something wrong with us if I go behind that camera and see that it hasn't been recording this whole time. I will shit a brick. Like, for some reason, I think that's
the preamble. Yeah, nothing's been recorded for the past 35 minutes.
If somebody's actually watching this, just know that
Aaron shits bricks.
I'm about 45% certain that it is recording.
I have no idea if it's recording. So like,
there's no light indication.
Yeah, I don't see anything. I don't see any life at all.
He hasn't been over there for a while.
Yeah.
He didn't get up and start anything. We just had been talking for a while before.
I don't know, guys. We'll see.
We'll be able to look at this moment and say,
yep,
you stupid motherfucker.
Well, we won't be able to look at it. We'll be able to remember it.
Yeah.
We're doing good.
I hate to see it. Well, you won't be able to see it.
The neighbors are probably looking at us like, hey, the guy's leaning over on his window. He's like, hey, Susie, come look at this. These four idiots are talking to each other.
They're not recording us. Don't worry.
They're not recording, though. They're idiots.
Are you boys off your rocker? You okay?
No, never. Yeah.
Okay. Well, Justy, go ahead and peek your head and look at the screen and see if you see.
No. Honestly, at this point, I kind of want it to be a surprise.
Yeah, it's great.
It's got to be a surprise.
Okay. Well, it is. But if you want to check, you can.
Okay. Yeah, we trust you, Peter.
A lot of trust here.
Yeah.
All right. Can
I ask a question to the group?
Aaron, question to the group.
All right. So, is there anything different that we can do next year that we haven't done in the past that you guys would like to do? Quinlan, don't say paintball. Do not say paintball.
Quinlan, go ahead. Quinlan first.
Go ahead, Keith.
We've refreshed my frame of thought.
Please.
I think I would love to play paintball. I'm just going to throw it out. Nobody wants to play paintball.
It's not a bad option.
And really just one person has vetoed it, and it's not great, but we're going to get it. We're going to get it done. We were actually going to play this year, but there were some travel disruptions that we don't have to get into. We unfortunately were not able to, but not any one individual's fault. Collectively didn't end up
as happening. A group, as a unit. It didn't work out
as a unit.
Yeah.
As a collective wolf pack.
Yeah, exactly. As a unit. Together we're a unit, and we also just have one absolute unit in the group.
Yep.
This guy.
Correct. Me.
He's a unit.
Okay, so paintball for Quinlan.
Yeah.
Paintball is the activity Quinlan
would love to do that.
Next year. Aaron, what would you like to participate in, good sir?
Okay, we've done this before. We did it once. So I'm going to say it kind of counts, but not really. Whitewater rafting,
yes,
the first year
you.
Was actually super fun. I mean, we did it literally 9 years ago.
Right.
It, maybe beautiful, we should give it a go again. Wonderful views. The water felt great. Awesome experience. I think we should do it next year. Pete?
I'm down for that. Yes.
Very Hard down. Yes. Very down. Shout out to the Whitewater Rafting Company out here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Good yep.
folk.
Yeah.
I was able to go last year.
Nice.
Oh, that's nice. I actually made a solo reservation last year, if you don't remember, Pete.
Right,
but
right. It was a
you didn't want to go.
Hungy, mungy over that day.
Should we go through that? So I think your listeners would want to hear that story super quick. I can set the stage.
I don't think we have to rehash that.
Yeah, okay. Let's already. Never mind. We won't rehash. Sorry.
Mount Centennial in Missoula. It is where the famous Montana M is. There's an M made of different plants and forgery or whatever. What's it called?
Foliage.
Forgery.
The M is forged onto the mountain.
Ooh.
Anyways, there's an M on a fucking mountain. I'd love to go see it.
Nice.
It's pretty dope. It's in Missoula.
I'm down. Yeah.
And there's a bunch of other cool spots in Montana. They have a big mining town.
Oh, okay.
That has these massive mines. Look pretty neat. Look pretty sharp. Look like a good time. Wish we could go there, but we'll have to do it in 2023 or any other of the 90 years. We plan to come.
What are you, Justin?
For pessimistic Aaron, but I believe 90.
You were somewhat alluded just a moment ago, but my province out there, parts of Montana.
Yeah.
We definitely went outside of our comfort zone on Glacier, and it was a great time. So might as well hit the momentum from there.
I love that.
What
I love that.
Like a Cessna or something. We rent Ooh. Out like two Cessnas or something and get like flyovers. Mm. I think that would be outstanding.
What's a Cessna?
Small plane.
Speaking of planes, Aaron, you're a pilot now. How does it fly for America?
As an official pilot.
As an official commercial. No. It feels great to be in the air. I won't lie. It's terrifying, but at the same time, it's probably the coolest thing I've ever done. But I'll be completely, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't doubting or questioning either my abilities or my drive, my will to do this, right? Because it's...
So have you been up there and like flown it yourself at this point, or are you just learning or like, how does that work?
A few times, during your...
He flies like a bird.
Yeah. During your journey to get your license, you'll fly solo a few times, which means the instructor isn't sitting next to you. Right. But the first up until like lesson 15, right? Like 15 hours.
And which, what lesson are you on?
I'm on like, I think Sunday is going to be like 8 and 9. Right. Yeah. So you have to get to 40 to get, to qualify FAA regulations to sit for the exam, the written and the actual flight exam. But in my first lesson, it was actually, I thought this was kind of weird. I'm literally driving, the airport's like half a mile from my house. And when I moved here 15 years ago, I was a young kid. I wanted to do it. I didn't have the money or the capacity to do it on my own. So my mom said, hell no, you're not doing this. But 15 years later, I'm driving by the airport, and it's super close to my house. I'm like, why don't I just go do this? I go to the flight school. I'm like, hey, do you guys by any chance have any lessons today, any open slots? He's like, yeah, we can put you in like 2 hours. I start filling out some paperwork. I read up a little bit. I kind of just chill in their waiting room for the 2 hours. I didn't want to go home. I was kind of excited. And we did like 30 minutes of, you know, learning about the plane. We checked the fuel, we checked the landing gear, checked the windows, the doors, the avionics, which is the, you know, the comms once you have the headset on. And then finally, like an hour and a half into our lesson, we finally started taxiing. And it's kind of funny, the wheel, if you will, that doesn't move the wheels at all. You have pedals that you navigate as you're taxiing and as you're getting ready to turn on the runway. And as I'm doing that, I'm like, oh, okay, taxiing is pretty easy. Like, I'm not nervous at all. But then my instructor looks at me. He's like, all right, are you ready? He was, again, super relaxed guy. He was an engineer. He had a regular 9-to-5, but he's been flying for 20 years. So he does lessons. And so I could clearly see right off the bat that he wasn't going to be a super hard ass. But we're right at the start of the runway. And he's like, all right, you're going to take us off. Keep in mind, this is my first lesson ever. My dad is in the back seat, just like enjoying life. He is like a little kid in there with his headset. I paid $50 to have him there. Go ahead.
No, I just didn't realize your dad was like
my dad was there for my first lesson, which was awesome because he was able to get a couple cool videos of me. And
shout out Papa Arvizu.
Hey, shout out Serge. And as the instructor is like, all right, you're gonna take us off. All you're gonna do is you're gonna put your hand on the throttle. You're gonna count to three Mississippis, and then you're gonna pull up slowly. Okay, easy enough. We finished taxiing. He's like, all right, you got this? I'm like, I think so. And my dad takes a video of this, and I start pushing the throttle, boom, 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 boom. And I'm like, wait, this isn't going that quick. And like 3/4 of the way through, it really hits. And then that's when I literally stopped because I thought I'd done something wrong. It's like the instructor took over, pushed the rest of the throttle. Then I started pulling up. And as soon as I started pulling up for the first time and I saw that it was literally me, because there's two, two controls, right? And the instructor can take over whenever. But when we were pulling off the ground, it was all me. And I was just like, this is, first of all, it was a beautiful, gorgeous day, not a single cloud in sight. But as we were taking off the first 100, 200, 300,000 feet, it felt really like turbulent to me. But the instructor looked at me, he's like, man, if you think that's turbulent, you're not going to, like, when you're in snow, when you're in the rain, when you're like, it's cloudy and it's rainy, like you're going to feel everything. Cause in a big plane, it takes a like really wavy weather for you to like feel something. Cause it's a beast of a plane, of a machine.
And he was just like cool as a cucumber this entire time.
Yeah, dude, it was. And as soon as we got up there, like you could literally just like move the window and just like see down like 3,500 feet. And it was a gorgeous day. We went by some beaches that were like literally a beautiful lake that was like 3 to 4 miles away from my house that I'd never seen.
Dude, that's such an amazing first time unbelievable experience.
Super lax instructor.
Were you like, when you were pulling up, were you just like adrenaline coursing through your veins, like invigorated the entire time? You're like, my dad's.
Yeah, it was super cool. But
so recommend it.
I'd super recommend, but you have to it's incredibly expensive, and B, you have to have the stomach for it. Look, I love it.
Some nuts on you.
I love it, but I'd be lying if I said I wasn't. I was genuinely scared. So I know a ton of people who would never get in a plane like that, let alone fly it, right? So I definitely recommend.
I went skydiving 2 years ago for the first time.
Wow.
And like, man, I know exactly what you mean. Like, you're up in that really small plane, you're getting like battered around.
Yeah. You're and jumping then out like of a
open,
live plane.
Yeah, they just like open the door and they're like, all right. And like, I like stuff like that. Mm-hmm. I like surfing. I like some of the more like,
is it safe?
And I loved it. But I didn't actually find the free falling to be that scary. Like that was really invigorating.
The jumping.
You don't even have time to like think about it when you're free falling. You're like, this is just dope.
It's happening.
And you have a person on your back, right? But what I found what was scary is like when the parachute opens, I had this like, you know, like the scene in Toy Story where they like to throw the down and they just like parachute right there, whatever. Like those types, just like the just drop. But it was like, no, it was like you're paragliding, right? Yeah. So he was like, all right, I'm letting go. And he gave me the handles. And I was like, shit, if I let go of these, I don't like know what's going on.
Yeah.
I have no clue what's going on. And we're just like literally doing like figure eights through the air. It was pretty cool.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
My buddy did it with me. He landed like 100 yards away from me because we jumped at the same time.
That's awesome, dude.
And his, I've never seen Long Island Skydiving Center.
Okay.
Like an hour and a half from New York. I mean he was darker green than the fucking Grinch. Like he was not looking good. He had fun, but I don't think it was for him.
Yeah. Two awesome events, man.
Yeah,
good. I mean, that's way more. Aaron, question for you though.
Yeah.
For one, can you just do them in like I want to do one lesson, or is it like you have to sign up for like a batch of lessons, or how did that work?
So great question. I took my first lesson in like early summer, and then it's a huge financial commitment and time commitment. Like, right, you want to do it right because you want to study, you want to make sure you know the plane inside and out, you want to make sure you can fly without even looking, right, just relying on your instruments. So I wasn't really sure if it was for me. I took a couple months, but just to put it in perspective, that first lesson did not count in my logbook as an actual hour towards the 40 because too much time had elapsed between number one and number two. So there's no rule.
Do you have to buy them on like a per lesson basis, or how does that work?
Yeah. And it's incredibly subjective. The flight school, because it's like Princeton Airport and Princeton Flight School, and your instructor have like all the say on when you get to go to the FAA and take the written. And so it can be 40, it can be 45, it can be 50. But to me, if each hour costs you X amount of, you know, hundreds of dollars, I want to work my ass off, know the plane better than anybody, be really comfortable in the simulator with, knowledge questions, the science. There's a lot of science shit. I'm not great with science, but there's a lot of physics stuff in the manual that you have to learn. You have to learn about all the forces that you're experiencing in flight, on the ground, right? So I'm going all in. I'm making sure that this is something that I'm going to be really comfortable with. I just want to be comfortable.
And would you say one of the reasons that you have like the time or the ability to do this is because you work on a much more like work from home flexible type schedule?
Absolutely. And the airport's half a mile. It literally, the airport is half a mile from the gym. And then so I literally just either hit some golf balls, shoot some basketballs, work out, sure, go up in the sky for a little bit, go home, sure, sleep another day. Right. That's literally
play a little Call of Duty.
Yeah. Play a little Call of Duty. But that's an ideal like Sunday for me. Sure. Waking up, golf, gym, food, fly, Xbox, go to sleep.
You know, that's a good question. Money. Justin, let's say you have a full Sunday, no work, nothing.
I love it.
Right. You have you know, it's coming up. Right. And you have some time. What do you plan? Like, what's going to be your ideal Sunday? It doesn't have to be anything crazy, but like if you could just like have like an ideal Sunday, even if it's just like sleeping in and sleeping.
Most of the time, studying. I counseling position. Most of my Sundays, I'm actually going to sleep in, so sleeping until like.
You have to love it.
Eat a good meal and just get worse and back.
Yeah,
just a good Asian Sunday.
Let's say we got work out of the equation. I mean, we were on the links today, and I mean, I think you had by far the most aesthetically pleasing
golf swing
of all of us.
He's got such a beautiful swing, especially like, with that three.
Well, like, what is he, uncle or second? He's up there. He's in the lineage.
Cousin.
Yep.
Like, I'm a straight jaboni out there. So, like, do you golf much over the summers? Or, like, do you hit the links or anything? Or go shooting or anything like that? Those types of activities.
I did find those. In the rain a couple times by the time. It's over.
No, you look good.
And so you recently moved into your own place, right? How is that process? How is that transition? Do you enjoy it? And where are you now?
Shout out Fort Wayne.
You.
Oh.
Still live nearby, so I'm not entirely. Developing skills, life skills,
Good to be close to the family.
Yeah,
it's amazing. It's a huge benefit. And I mean, do you think you've enjoyed that so far? Then like, because it's a big difference. I mean, I moved in to my studio in Manhattan in January, so 9 months ago or 10 months ago, whatever it is.
Studio in Manhattan, ladies and gentlemen.
Beautiful apartment.
This guy is balling.
Always balling.
Sorry, go ahead.
But I've really enjoyed living by myself. Like, I think there's a lot of autonomy. I think, like, you know, I think you just have a lot more freedom over your own schedule. And that's why I kind of asked that previous question, is because, like, sometimes I feel like on the weekends, you know, when I do have that time or I don't have something planned, it is really easy to just, like, not make any plans. And honestly, sometimes those are, like, my favorite days. But something I found difficult is to kind of take the step needed to like make a plan or to go out and like golf or throw a party or, you know, like, I don't know, make basketball plans or like something like that. But so that's something like I'm trying to work on. But I was kind of curious about that.
I mean, that makes sense. I mean, one of the things that I wish I learned sooner, or just everyone should learn sooner, is that just because when you have more freedom, that generally leads to more responsibility to do everything. And that's what we kind of learn in school indirectly, is like they build us a schedule, you have to follow the schedule, maintain like a clear path. And unfortunately, when we get out of high school, especially at Culver, you start college, well, hopefully those habits are ingrained in you, so it just becomes instinctive. But, you know, a lot of those, Culver graduates, they graduate Culver, they get that much freedom, you know, from the strict schedule of Culver, and they fall into bad habits, or they don't realize the importance.
Only a few shit apples, but we mainly got golden apples coming out of the Culver military.
Yeah, I mean, it's an important point, and I think there's like a lot of, you know, there's a lot of ways to view that, and I think the other way to view it is that, like, you know, hopefully Culver did instill those values, and I think I would attribute the fact that, like, we're at least self-aware of it, right? And able to realize, like, oh, I'm being a piece of shit. Or like, oh, okay, maybe like right now I don't have any structure. I'm going to build structure. I'm going to create that. I'm going to take that necessary step to do that. Mm-hmm. What about you, Aaron? Because I know, so I know you started a new opportunity a little while ago. I guess it's been a longer than a little while now. You moved kind of back into your area and have been really enjoying that. We were just talking about some of the work from home autonomy. You know, would you consider moving back into the city or, you know, back into like your own place, or what are kind of your thoughts on that? And what have you enjoyed in the past? Cause you've done that in the past.
Yeah.
Very similar living situation to what I have in New York.
No,
right now.
Beautiful spot. Yeah. No, very, very similar, but, I mean, it's a great question. I don't know. I have to figure my shit out. Honestly, folks at home. I mean, let's do a polling question. If you could, would you move to New York City, Washington, D.C., or Charlotte, North Carolina? Those right now are my top three. That may change, but one of the things that you touched on that
Dallas?
I mean, everyone knows I love Texas, but it's a little too soon.
Yes, sir.
The fact that I can just like work from anywhere. I mean, my home office is in Hoboken / Hudson Yards in Manhattan, right? But I don't have to go in that often, and we have folks on our team who are in Texas, Illinois, Georgia, Jersey, all over. So I love my job, and I love the balance that my team has. It's great.
Yeah, I mean, that's pretty crazy. Yeah. I spent 3 years out of college working in an office, which was fine. You know, it is very structured. But man, like time goes away. Like it gets away from you during the week. Like you're in the office, you're working. If you have to work past like if you have a job like I did where like I typically had to stay in the office past like 5 p.m., you know, you're getting back home, then you have to have dinner. Mm-hmm. And then like
you don't have a lot of time for anything else.
If I want to work out or whatever, like I don't really have that time. Whereas like now during COVID, I spent 2 years working virtually. And now it's like, I really only have to go into the office kind of once a week at most twice a week. And in those off days, I find not only am I significantly more efficient because the faster that productive, I get my work done, productive, the faster I get my work done, that basically means I've earned, right? I've afforded myself more time to do the other stuff that I want.
I love that way of thinking. Yes.
And so it's like, not only am I being more productive and efficient with my work, but like also a lot of the times it's much higher quality, right? Whereas like now I've noticed when I do go into the office, like I do not get much done.
Oh yeah.
Right. And so like the days I do go to the office is like a little frustrating for me because I just feel like a lot of stuff gets away from me. And I love to like go to the gym right after work. Mm-hmm. I work out. Right. And it's like a nice mark to the end of my day, like 5 o'clock, I'll go to the gym, I'll get a nice dinner, and then I'll still have 3-4 hours left in my evening, you know, cause I go to bed at like 11 or 12. To do whatever I want. Sometimes it's playing Call of Duty. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's getting a head start on the work for tomorrow because I can do that because I have my office at my own place.
I love that.
But I think the interesting distinction to draw is like a lot of, you know, individual, I did have those 3 years working in an office, right? Mm-hmm. So I knew what it was like. I was able to develop a lot of professional skills I needed to work in it, like to like be in a professional workspace.
MDP.
But a lot of kids graduate from college, like going directly into a virtual world, like you don't necessarily get to develop those skills. And so I think it's a really interesting problem that a lot of different employers are trying to solve right now.
I mean, it's a big problem for a lot of employers, especially because of the resources that they've already allocated to rent out a space, right? Whether it be a long-term lease or like a company-owned building, something like that. At least I know that's been one of the main reasons why certain other people that I work with have been called back into the office. And there have been a lot of incentives by certain employers to either free lunches or parking validation or offering a lot of different types of benefits while they're at the office to make sure that everyone's comfortable coming back. But yeah, I love that. I don't have to.
Yeah. And I think, I mean, and like hiring out of college is like tough right now. Like it's highly, highly competitive. It's really tight labor market still. And so like a lot of students are demanding like, hey, I want
flexibility.
Yeah. I want flexibility to work from home.
Yeah.
And if you can't offer that as an employer, you're no longer drawing from like the top bucket of talent.
Yeah.
Right. And so it's like, what do you do? And this is obviously only for like positions where you can actually work.
Right. There's right. Obviously. Positions. Yeah.
Like, an example is like, you know, you work with like your clients where like there's probably a big benefit to working with a lot of them in person. Right. And some of that you can do virtually. Right. You know, but And I think one person who I'd be curious your perspective on this, Pete, is like, sure. I feel out of all of us, you've probably the most autonomy over your, or maybe not, but like the most autonomy over your schedule. Cause I mean, you own your business, right? And you have your own studio at your place and like you have all that. How have you found it with regards to structuring your schedule? You know, inviting people on your podcast, like planning out your day to day, you know, work life balance to an extent.
To me, I have a simple philosophy: where there's structure, there's success. So the more structure I'm able to implement that's built around progress and value, the better I'm doing. And when that structure isn't acted upon, that's when, you know, I'm cutting myself short. So there's a lot of self-accountability, but when you manage your own business, at least in my experience, you have to put yourself in the mindset that, okay, you're not your own boss. You are the boss of following through on the promises and commitment you made to provide.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the contract. You already signed a contract with yourself. Now you just got to execute.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. And you're the boss in the sense that you have to manage how efficient you are with your time.
Mm-hmm.
The more efficient you're able to make your processes and the more structured you're able to make your continual progress, the better off you're doing.
Yeah. Mm. When do you think that kind of ideology, that mentality clicked into place? Because at Culver, you know, you were a battalion commander of Company B. At Baylor, he was captain of the Baylor rugby team. And now, you run two separate businesses. It's like, it's impressive, right? And I think the question I would have is like, what tips would you give to your broader audience to manage around some of that, that to like define that structure if you're struggling? Because like that's something I typically struggle with a lot when I have like, you know, a lot, some like free time and I've gone ahead of my work. And I'm just like, I'm going to take it easy and I feel like crap because I've just like procrastinated or something like that.
Wake up at the same time every day. Second thing, make your fucking bed right when you wake up. Third thing,
yell at your friends to wake up.
Fourth thing,
a gallon of I like that. A gallon of water.
Your boys to get the fuck up and get her going.
Send the first sergeant notes.
Energy is everything. I believe you got to wake up with energy, and you have to come out of the gates setting the standard high. That's why drinking the water, waking up at the same time, and making my bed are very
key,
like essential boxes I have to check to know that okay. We have put ourselves in a position to be the best Peter Hamm we can today. Mm. Now it's up to you to do it. Do I always do it? No. I ain't perfect. Sometimes I'm a beach and I get a little lazy. But majority of days, go to bed proud of myself, which that's the goal.
Yeah. Now here's a question.
More importantly, though, I like to make others proud and happy.
Fair enough. No, I was just going to ask, you know, what is, if you have one thing you want to work on, you know, like.
We got a whole Santa Claus list.
Well, let's go around the horn and say one thing like we want to work on with ourselves. We could do every day. Right. I think, you know, I don't know what I have a lot of things I have to work on as well.
Quinlan just perfect.
No, I'm not. I'm not. I think for me, I'm really bad.
Okay,
at procrastinating, right? That's one example of something I want to get better at. And that's why I was asking you the questions about structure, right? Because I think I can tend to let that, I can like lose some of the structure in my days because I'll procrastinate something. I'll push one task into the next, which is kind of how I've always functioned. But it is something I want to get a better handhold on.
I mean, if I'm supposed to give my 2 cents on that, I guess I can. The only thing that's kind of helped me with that is this philosophy that action leads to motivation, leads to, it's like a triangle. Action leads to motivation, which leads to accomplishment, which leads to action, which leads to motivation. There's, have you all seen that triangle?
No.
There's some sort of, triangle.
I think that's a pyramid.
but the common philosophy is that people are waiting for that motivation to come to their life, where sometimes you just gotta start doing shit. You just gotta get up. You gotta go for a walk. You gotta go for a run. You gotta call your buddy. You gotta. For me, I do weird shit. I say quote of the day, word of the day.
Mm-hmm.
I'll do. We haven't done word of the day in a while, or I'll just do, you know, Friend Friday, where I text five friends. Something. Sometimes you got to take action for the motivation to come. I think that's something that helps. Procrastination.
Got to have five friends to text. Yeah, okay.
You got five here. One.
Oh, two, sure.
Three, four, five.
What about you, Justin? Over the next, let's say, 365 days.
We weigh the same as three people.
Something you want to work on or improve. Yeah.
Don't be basic.
I was basic.
That's fine. Y'all can be basic. Aaron, you better give us.
I have a good one.
No.
Jesse,
you're on the mic.
Communication overall. Just initiating conversation.
I like that.
You're a good communicator, Dusty.
I think so too.
Anyone who you talk to would be honored.
I agree.
There's sexy women out there. Jesse's single.
Love me sexy.
Love me sexy.
Oh, yeah. We're going to put together a Hinge profile for Justin single. This evening. I've got some dynamite photos of him from the glacier hike.
Quinlan takes great pictures.
Smart. Smart. Young. Good credit. No kids.
Great shape.
Half Filipino.
Good looking.
Great card player. Great golf player.
Aesthetically pleasing golf form.
Good tan. Minimal back hair.
Minimum.
Actually, no back hair. No, yeah, that's Aaron.
Yep.
Speaking of
me, guys.
Someone with a lot of back hair. You said you had a good one for it.
Yeah.
Aaron doesn't have back hair. He's got a hairy face.
Not anymore. But this
is that laser?
It's a silly one, but honestly, just going to sleep. No, definitely not. Going to sleep earlier. If I could go to sleep and like actually be out every single night by midnight and get like, I don't have to wake up super early for work. Sometimes I may need to wake up to finish something, or maybe I'm feeling frisky and I'm going to go work out or something, but I could do 12 to 7:30 every single night. And I don't, which is great, which is fantastic. So I need to improve on that. And that's number one on my list, you know.
That's such a good one. I just feel I wake up so tired sometimes.
Yeah.
And like, damn, that's a really good one. And I think there's probably some really easy steps we can take to do that.
Sure. Like screen time, eat, like diet.
Have a cup of tea or something before you go to bed. Well, herbal tea. Before you go to bed, read. Yeah, put away your screen.
Exactly.
Yeah. I mean, I have the same thing. It's like I'll look at my, you know, phone before
them
I go to bed.
Them teas
like
are pretty popular.
Like, what the fuck am I doing? Like,
yeah, but I mean,
them hot
I have
teas.
A long day tomorrow. Why am I stealing?
Why am I doing that?
Why am I stealing time away from my next day?
Yeah.
But I think part of me, like the reason I think I do that is it's the, like, you know, maybe sometimes I'm so busy during the day. I'm like, I finally only get this like hour and a half or whatever to myself late at night to like go through my phone, TikTok, or like whatever it is. It's like that's not actually like the most beneficial for me. You're stealing time away from your next day. That's like how I think
about it. That's a great way to think about it. That should be a motivator to not do it so often, you know.
Totally.
I struggle with that too, Aaron. I'm someone who never has had a bedtime, but I always wake up the same time.
Nice.
Around the same time. Not a good thing. Trust me. Not all sunshine and rainbows. Sometimes we'll go to bed at 5, and next thing you know, we're up at 7.
Hey, it happens. Got to do dad things.
Yep, got to be a dad.
Got to be a dad. Uh-oh, I'm a father. Yep.
Love being a dad. Shout out Hattie.
We love you.
Shout out Hattie.
Well, gentlemen, I'd like to ask one more question.
Sure.
A good question.
Uh-huh.
Last one, the best one. Quinlan, in one sentence, what makes the fellas special? Which the fellas, ladies and gentlemen, is the group of fine gentlemen who we have this annual reunion with. Again, this is our 9th year coming together on the shores of Flathead Lake. We've gathered in different places, but Flathead has been our main
we always gravitate
gathering ground
to Flathead Lake.
A lot of other friendship groups, maybe in Culver or even all around America, wish they still had a connection like ours. What makes the connection of ours, the fellas, special to you, brother?
Yeah, that's a good question. Look, I think we have a really unique group of folks here, right? So, you know, myself, Aaron, Justin, Pete, Eric, and Ryan are all completely different types of people. We all have different personalities. We all do different things, right? And I think just like the fact that we're so different is one thing that I love about our group. But what I think makes us special is the fact that, like, I know I can say, I can do, I can act anything, anything, like period, stop, no matter what happens, anything I do, if it's the worst thing on earth, if it's the best thing on earth. I know you guys would like bend over backwards for me.
No, right? Bending over. Yeah, I'm just kidding.
I know y'all would do anything. No matter any situation.
We'd die
and,
for you.
And I think that type of friendship, I think that's incredibly unique. And I think it's one of the most valuable things in life, over money, over status, over ambition, over power, anything. I think being able to find friends who will do anything for you no matter what, and, like, you know, value you for the person that you are. Right. I can act exactly how I want to act and be exactly who I am around this group of people. And a lot of the times you can't do that in a professional environment. I can't do that with new people I'm getting to meet. I can't do that. You know, even with some of my, like, you know, my family members, my sisters, whatever, you know, I can't totally be 100% like vulnerable and et cetera, and, like, around you guys, I can totally do that. Right. And that's something unique, and special, and different. And it is incredibly priceless. And I'm super, super, you know, lucky and fortunate to have met you guys and to have established and continued to keep such a strong connection with you guys over the years. So,
fellow strong.
Yeah, very well said. I mean,
Aaron,
I
in your words, what makes a fellow special?
I think Quinlan hit it right on the head, but I'll sort of just very quickly and briefly just add support, love, and care. That's what it's all about. That's what these friendships are about. And no matter what happens, however much time has elapsed between our previous conversation, between the last time that we saw each other, there's just always a lot of support with our personal lives, professional lives, like our hobbies, our mental health, our physical health. There's just a lot of support in every avenue of your life that I can count on these five guys for, and I will always reciprocate that. And I feel very, very lucky, and I'm grateful every day that I'm able to have this type of support, love, and care from these guys.
Well, I ain't gonna be too soft like my predecessors.
It's okay.
Just kidding. Love what both of them said, and I gotta piggyback off of it. The uniqueness of the group is truly world class. We have a Wisconsinite piano master, private equity guru, Quinlan Smith, as a part of the group. 180 pounds, 6-pack abs. We have Aaron Arvizu, Mexico City, born and raised. Now, somehow lives in the Big Apple, raised in Princeton, New Jersey. Top notch.
Yep.
Justin, a Filipino scholar, comes from an amazing family of scholars, and he was raised amongst the corn. Downstairs, we got RC3. Well, if you know him, you know he's one of a kind. And then we got the French, Eric Modui, who's pretty, I mean, he's pretty European. He's up there. He's European. He's got the whole mannerisms, crosses his legs pretty seamlessly, likes escargot, all that stuff, long hair, combs it a lot. European. Good at rugby. finessery when it comes to tennis and other unique sports. And love Eric. So we got a Frenchman, a Filipino cornman, a Wisconsin cheesehead piano master, Princeton, New Jersey's finest, with roots from good old Mexico City, and then a big Texan sprinkled in. It's just a beautiful thing, y'all. It's just a beautiful thing.
It's great.
Oh, yeah. NRC3's bitch ass. I'm about to beat his ass right after this.
All right, Justin.
Justy, what do you think makes it so special?
I'll just elaborate on all three of you guys said, because you kind of hit that nail on the head. You know, the fact that we all want the best for each other. Mm-hmm. And everyone is surrounded with people that want to raise you up as well and not break you down. So being around you guys, that's definitely a special feeling.
Amen.
And just being overall trusting with each other. The fact that I can trust each and every one of you. You never. That's something you always need to value.
Can't put a price on good old friendship, ladies and gentlemen.
I love it.
It's a beautiful thing. It really is.
Peter, it's been a pleasure.
It's been a pleasure. Quinlan, any words of wisdom to the audience tonight? Where can they connect with you? TikTok, Top Challenger, Instagram, your website. Where do we sign up? Where do we get to learn more? Where do we buy your OnlyFans?
No OnlyFans, but you can download my app Top Challenger. Follow me on it for my workouts.
Download Top Challenger, or be a bitch, or not be a bitch, but be physically unfit.
If
you want to be healthier and better, stronger, faster, leaner, sexier. You go to the App Store right now. Download Top Challenger.
100%. But. You know, I'll just leave it with three words, and I'll just say peace, love, and tie-dye.
Love it. Thank you, Peter.
Love to see it.
It was a pleasure.
Jesse, any words of wisdom?
Everything that's already been
said. Love to see it. Love to see it. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we had a fantastic evening. We hope you had a fantastic evening yourself. We are always trying to keep the good vibes at all-time highs. If you enjoyed tonight's episode, make sure to share it with your mom, dad, sister, uncle, cousin.
Dog.
Friend. Dog.
Teacher. Coach.
Teacher. Share with your
doctor,
teacher.
Dentist.
Especially if she's a coach. Anyways, no, I'm just kidding. Well, maybe not. Actually, send me a resume. Actually, we're just having a good time. Remember, Hamm Planet Podcast is for entertainment purposes only. And we hope you were entertained. We love you. We appreciate you. We will see your beautiful faces very soon. Hasta la vista.